say waiting. Now we are doing the compression strength of the grain sander. When we pour the molten metal, the different types of the forces will apply on the mold itself. Most commonly, the compression strength we want to test it for before pouring the molten metal. Here, first when we are finding the compression strength test, we want to write the tabular column. For tabular column, first we want to take the sand, clay, moisture. Then what is the compression strength will come, we want to write down here. Here, standardly we want to prepare the specimen diameter and height. The specimen height is the 50.8, diameter also 50.8. As per the American Foundry Men's Society, here applied force will apply here reaction force. First we want to write the tabular column. When we want to prepare the specimen for standardly we want to take the sand weight, clay weight and moisture. Here we have taken for sand is 90%, clay is 4%, moisture is 6%. For part A, first is the constant clay and varying moisture percentage. The part B is the constant moisture and varying clay. For constant clay, we have taken the clay percentage constantly. Here moisture will vary. Here clay will vary. Moisture is constant. Now as for this, the sand weight is the 90% means the totally 155 grams wants to come. The sand weight is 139.5. The clay weight is 6.2. Moisture is 6%. 9.3 ml we can take it for gram itself also. Now as for this, we want to prepare the specimen. The apparatus required now, the universal testing machine itself. Here it will give the compression to the sand. Here shackles will come, sir. There is a different types of shackles. This shackles is flat shackle. It is used for compression strength. Here two pins is there. It wants to come for bottom side like this. We want to fix the shackles, both the shackles. Here we want to prepare the specimen and we want to place it. It is the dial indicator. The dial indicator itself, the two needles will come. Here black color needle and red color needle. When we give the compression force, both the needles move simultaneously. When the sand will broken, the red color needle stops where the sand will broken. The black color needles comes for initial position. We want to note down the reading for the red color. When we are doing again manually, we want to make it for zero. Next is the mixing jar. This mixing jar is used for mix the sand, specimen tube, plate. This plate is used for, we want to place the specimen tube like this. When we do the sand ramming, we want to place it like this. It is the sand rammer. Now we mix the sand. As for our tabular column, we want to take the sand weight for 139.5. Now we are taking the silica sand for 139.5. We are taking for 90% of the sand, 139.5. Now we have taken the sand weight is 139.5. Next we want to mix the clay. Clay we are taking for 4%. For 4% it will come for 6.2 grams. Now take the clay weight for 6.2 grams. Now we have taken the clay weight is 6.2. Minimum 2 minutes properly we want to mix the clay and sand. Minimum 3 minutes we want to mix like this properly. Now we want to take the moisture for, we have mixed the clay and sand. Now we want to mix the moisture. We want to take it for 9.3 ml. We can take it for gram itself also. Take it for 9.3. Now moisture is taken. Now properly, minimum 2 minutes, we want to mix the moisture and sand properly. We want to mix this. Minimum 2 minutes. Now mixing is fully completed. Now we want to do the ramming. When we do the ramming, use the specimen tube. Take the plate, properly place it like this. Now put the all the sand from the tube itself. Now use the paper. Put the sand all in tube itself. When you are lifting bottom itself, carefully lift the plate itself. Place it like this. Now remove the lock. Once the lock is released, means here they are given the standard height lines. The middle line is the standard height line. When we are doing the ramming operation properly, 3 times the clockwise we want to do the ramming. Observe here. 1, 2, 3. Observe here, the middle line is exactly matched for this height. It is the specimen height. Once the ramming is completed, means again lock this. Now remove the plate, take the rod. Reverse the specimen tube. Now properly remove the specimen. Now check the specimen height and diameter. Now specimen height is 5.8 exact. Diameter also 5.8. Now place it in between the shackles. Carefully lift the sand. Place it. Now uniformly rotate the hand wheel. Now it is compressing the sand. The certain compression pressure, the sand wheel broken. When the sand wheel broken, we want to note down the reading. The sand is now, as per the specimen, the compression strength is 4.2. here one division equal 0.2. the compression strength is 4.2. the black color needle came for initial position, the red color needle stopped for where the sand is broken, the 4.2. now as per the 4% of the clay, 6% of the moisture, the compression strength of the green sand is 4.2 kg per centimeter square. The next is the procedure will be same. The procedure same here. The moisture percentage increased for 1%. Next part B also the procedure will be same. Here clay is increased. Here we are increased for 2% of the clay. When the moisture is increased, the strength will decreases. When the clay is increased, the strength will. Now as per the 4%, 4.2 compression strength. Here the clay percentage is 4%, clay moisture is increased for 7%, the strength is 3.5 kg per centimeter square. Here when the clay is increased, the strength will increase. The compression strength is 5 kg per centimeter square.